Hi guys and welcome back to a new video. My name is Emma if you don't know me and I make crochet tutorials here on YouTube. So today we are going to be doing crochet 101. We are going to be going over the basics, like basic stitches, basic like kind of techniques. So just as an overview of what I'm going to be covering today, I'll put it over here. I'm going to be showing you how to halter your hook, how to slip knot, how to chain, single crochet, half double crochet, and how to double crochet, as well as showing you how to like start a new row and also how to tie off. So yeah, it's just the basics, and if you know these skills, you will be flying. You're going to be able to do the majority of the stuff in my videos anyway, and probably the majority of patterns you'll be fine with after you know these skills. So I really hope you guys enjoy the video. Please remember to like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, please leave them down below, or any recommendations for future videos, also please leave them down below. And yeah, I think that's kind of it for me, so enjoy the tutorial and I will see you guys later. Bye. Hi everybody and welcome to the voiceover. I just want to briefly mention what I'm going to be using in this video. So I'm going to be using a 6mm hook and weight for chunky yarn, but please feel free to use whatever combination of hook and yarn you want to. And so to get started today, we're just going to look at the slip knot, and this is something you're going to need to start off any project. And this is what we're going to do before we even pick up our hook, okay? So what we're going to do for a slip knot is we're going to wrap our yarn around our two fingers into an X shape, like so, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the top piece of yarn and we're going to push it underneath that one there. We're going to push it underneath the bottom piece of yarn and we're going to form a U shape. Like so. So if you grab the top, you can see it's like kind of a U shape. Like that. And now we're going to remove our fingers, grab onto the two pieces of yarn there at the bottom, and we're going to pull up like so, just to tighten it. And that is your slip knot. It's as easy as that. And I'm going to show you this one more time in real time so you can see what it might look like in real time. So we're going to wrap the yarn around our two fingers into an X, get the top piece, push it underneath into a U shape, pull that up, remove our fingers, and pull down. And to make the loop smaller, all you need to do is grab that short bit of yarn and pull it down to make the loop smaller. Okay, so next step, we are going to need to know how to hold your hook. So this can be kind of tricky when you're getting started because it feels kind of awkward, but and there's so many different ways of doing it, but this is just how I do it. So what I do, so you have your loop and you're going to want to get your hook and stick it through the loop like so. And what you'll notice is, so that long piece that is attached to your yarn, if you pull on that, it's going to make your loop looser. And if you pull on the shorter strand, it's going to make your loop tighter. So you're going to want to find like a balance in regards to like tension of your loop on your hook. So it's going to kind of want to move up and down like that. Okay, so to get started on how to hold your hand like that. Grab onto your yarn with your ring and pinky. Bring up your pointer finger into like a pyramid with your yarn, and then you're going to grab onto your slip knot with your thumb and your middle finger like so. And that's how I hold my hook anyway. So to show you again, grab on, make your pyramid, and then grab onto your slip knot with your thumb and your middle finger like so. And one more time, grab on, bring it up, and grab on with your middle and thumb onto your slip knot. Okay, so next up, we're gonna go how to create a chain. So this, you've probably seen this in my videos before. I've done this a few times, so you may be already familiar with it. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna hold our hook and yarn in the same way as we did before, and we are gonna face our hook downwards, okay? So pointing to the floor. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab and wrap our hook around the yarn in an anti-clockwise way, so up to the right, and we're just going to bring it through the loop like so. I'm going to show you again. So we're going to face our hook downwards and we're going to wrap our hook around our yarn anti-clockwise, and we're going to just bring it right through the loop like so. Face your hook downwards, bring it up to the right,
and right through the loop. I'm going to do it again, face your hook downwards, up to the right, and through the hoop. The loop. And so you're just going to keep doing that, and we're going to create a chain of 13 here, okay? So keep doing this until you get to 13 chains. And feel free to keep watching, like, feel free to do this along with me. And if you think I'm going, like, if this is going too fast for you, please feel free to slow it down. I think there's an option on YouTube that you could do that. So please feel free to do that if I am going a bit too fast. Okay, and here we are. Here's our 13 chains. And now that they are completed, we are going to start on our single crochet. So a single crochet is super easy. It's a great first one to know. And so we're just going to get straight into it. So we are going to do our first single crochet into the second chain from our hook, okay? So here's the first chain and here's the second. So that blue chain is the one you're going to want to stick your hook into. Okay, so you can see the hole there, kind of. So you are going to insert your hook into that second chain there, which is your first single crochet. So insert your hook, so stick it right through that chain. Okay, so we are going to wrap our hook around the yarn like so, and we are just going to pull it through the opening right there. So now we have two loops on our hook, okay? And what we're going to do is we are going to wrap our hook around the yarn again like so, similar to what we did on the chain, and we're going to pull it right through those two loops that are on our hook, okay? And then that is your first single crochet. So we're going to do that again, and we're going to stick our hook into the following chain, okay? So see that big hole? We're not putting it in there. We're going to put it into the smaller hole right beside it, okay? So insert your hook into the next chain. We are going to pull up a loop like so. So there are two loops on our hook. Now we're going to yarn over. And we're going to pull through two. And yarn over is basically just wrapping the yarn around your hook. And so we're going to go into the next stitch. Like so. And we are going to pull up a loop, which is basically pulling that yarn through using our hook. And now we're going to yarn over and pull through two loops on our hook. Like so. So we're going to insert, wrap the hook around the yarn to bring it through, to pull up a loop. So we have two loops on our hook. We're going to yarn over and pull through two. And we're going to do that again. And so I've just sped it up here. Please feel free to single crochet along with me. So I'm just gonna be quiet now to let you guys figure it all out. But again, please feel free to slow this down if I am going too fast. I just sped it up for the sake of the video because it would be like an hour long if I didn't. Okay, so we are on our final single crochet of the round, or of the row. And And what we're going to do to start a new row is we are simply, actually I'm just going to show you a look of what the row looks like. Very pretty. Okay, so to start off a new row, we are going to chain one. So wrap it around and bring it through the loop, and that is your chain one. So now we are going to turn our work around like that, so the back side is facing us. So we are facing the back and we can see our chain one. And when you turn that chain one over, you can see like the V's that our stitches created up on top. And so our stitches for this row are going to be going underneath those V's. So we're going to stick our hook into the very first stitch underneath the V, and we're going to pull up a loop like so. So there are two loops on our hook. And now we're going to yarn over and pull through two loops. And that is your first single crochet of the row. So next we are going to go into the next stitch with a single crochet. So insert your hook. We're going to pull up a loop like so. And we're going to yarn over and pull through two. Then to do that again, we're going to insert our hook. We're going to pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two. And we're going to go all the way down the row doing this. And again, like I said before, slow it down if you need to. I'm going to go quite fast here. I'm going to speed it up a bit. But again, like I said, please slow it down if you need to. And please feel free to practice along with me. Okay, so here I am at the final stitch of the row, just here. So I'm going to insert my hook like that. I'm going to pull up a loop, two loops on my hook, yarn over, pull through two. So now I'm simply going to chain one, turn my work, and again I'm going to be going into that very first stitch with a single crochet like so. And this is our third and final round, so we are going to just go all the way down to the bottom of the row, and yeah, I'll meet you back when we're done. Okay, so here is the third row completed of single crochet, and this is what it's going to look like. So it's pretty dense. Yeah, great stitch all around. So to tie off, we're just going to chain one and lay our work just flat on the desk. And we're going to snip it off and pull it tight like so. And there we go. There is our single crochet sample. I really love the single crochet. Just it's really good for like bags and hats and stuff because it's so dense. And okay, so now we're going to be moving on to the half double crochet, which is arguably my favorite stitch. So we have our chain of 13 just here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to yarn over first of all. Before we do anything else, we're going to yarn over. So which is wrapping our yarn around our hook, okay? Like so. And now we're going to look at our chain, okay? So we're going to look. So we're going to count 1, 2, and 3. So we're going to place our first half double crochet into the third chain from our hook. So we are going to insert our hook like so. So there are 3 loops on our hook, okay? So 3 instead of 2 this time. So we're going to yarn over and pull up a loop like so. 3 loops on our hook. And what we're going to do, we're going to yarn over again and we are going to pull through all 3 loops on our hook. And that is your half double crochet. So to do that again, before we do anything, we are going to yarn over like this and we are going to insert our hook into the next chain. So there are 3 loops on our hook. So now we are going to yarn over again and pull through like so. So three loops on our hook again, and all that we're going to do is we're going to yarn over and we're going to pull through all three. So now for our next stitch, we are going to do the same thing again. So we're going to yarn over and insert our hook into the next chain. We are going to pull up a loop like so. We're going to yarn over and we're going to pull through all three. Show you one more time. So we're going to yarn over into the next stitch. We're going to pull up a loop. And now we're going to yarn over and pull through all three. Like so. So I'm going to speed up now. Please feel free again to practice along with me as I go down the row, and I will come back when we are finished the row. Okay, so here we are going into our final stitch of the row with our half double crochet. And to start off a new row here, all that we're going to do is we are going to chain two, so one and two, and we are going to turn our work. And again, we're going to notice, so those two chains are attached to a stitch of their own. So I'm going to pull it out, I'm going to show you right now what, okay. So right there, we're not going to want to put any stitches into that hole, okay? Nothing at all. So we are going to go into this one here, okay? So we're going to yarn over, insert our hook into that stitch there, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through all three, okay? And that is going to be the first stitch of our row. So insert your hook into the following stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through all three. So again, we're going to go all the way down the row again. And once we come to the end, I will show you once more how to start off a new row. Oh, and I'll just mention actually as well, the reason why we chain two at the end of the row is because the following row, like, we want to get to the height of a half double crochet. So by chaining two, you are getting up to that height. And that's similar to the way that we chained one when we did a single crochet, because a single crochet is like shorter. So you only need one. For this one, you need two. And then for the tallest one, which is the double crochet, we're going to be doing three. So that's why we do the different number of chains for each kind of stitch. So here we are at the final stitch of the row. So we're just going to complete that. And to start off our new row, we're going to chain two. We're going to turn our work. And we're going to do the exact same thing as last time. So we're going to insert, so yarn over, as always. So yarn over there and insert your hook into that stitch there. And you're going to go all the way down the row until you get to the end. And here we are at our final stitch. Now we're going to chain one. Oh, have a quick look. I do think this is my favourite stitch. I really do. I just think it looks so nice. I just think it looks really neat. Okay, so I'm chaining one here and I'm just going to cut it off the very same way that we did last time. So just cut it off and pull your hook upwards so that length of yarn comes right through like that, and we're just going to tighten it off like so. And that is our little tiny swatch. So now we are going to move on to the double crochet, which is the final stitch of this video. So we are going to get our chain again. And we are going to count four chains from our hook. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And so we're going to yarn over and place our very first stitch into the fourth chain from our hook. Okay, so insert your hook. So you have three loops on your hook, like so. And what we're going to do, we're going to pull up a loop. So wrap it around and pull it right through. So we have three loops on our hook. So now we are going to yarn over and pull through two loops, okay? So 1 and 2, and we're going to bring it up. And so we still have two loops on our hook, okay? And so we're going to yarn over again and we're going to pull through those final two loops on our hook. And that is your first double crochet. Okay, so we actually have two double crochets here because the first three chains we skipped count as our first double crochet. So we are going to insert our hook again, yarn over, pull up a loop, three loops on our hook there, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. And we're going to do another one. So we're going to yarn over. Oh, here's a, have a little look at what we've done so far. So yarn over, insert our hook into the next chain, pull up a loop like so, three loops on our hook now. Now we're going to yarn over and pull through two, and now we're going to yarn over again and pull through two. Amazing. Okay, so those are our four double crochets. We're going to keep going. So yarn over, insert your hook, we're going to pull up a loop like so. Now we're going to yarn over again and pull through two. And we're going to yarn over again and pull through two. So I'm just going to keep going down to the end of the row. Please feel free to follow along with me. Slow it down if you need to. And yeah, so just keep practicing all the way down the row, and I will come back to you when I am finished this row. Okay, so here is our final double crochet of the row. Okay, so that's what it's gonna look like. And so we are going to chain three this time, okay? To get to the height of our double crochet. So 1, 2, and 3. Like so, we're going to turn our work around and we are going to notice that those chain three that's attached to that first stitch, okay? So that means we are going to skip that stitch because it already has a double crochet in there, which is our chain three. So we're going to go into the second stitch, okay? So insert your hook into that second stitch after you have yarned over. Pull up a loop, three loops on your hook right there. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over again and pull through two. Okay, so we have two double crochets. So we yarn over into the next stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. So again, keep going all the way down this row, and I will come back to you when we are finished. And here we are at our final double crochet of the row. And so now we're just gonna have a little look at it. Gorge. And so we are going to chain three. Okay, so one, two, and three. We are going to turn our work around. We are gonna skip that first stitch that is attached to our chain three, and we're gonna go into the second stitch right there. And we are going to double crochet in there. And so we're going to go all the way down the row again until we reach the end. And once we're there, I am going to show you a different kind of turning chain, simply because while I think the chain three skip a stitch is a great method, it's just not for me. But I did want to show you because that is what is normally kind of done. But like I said, it's not for me. I like to use a different method. And I'm going to show you that now in 2 seconds. Because with this, I find it hard to get a straight edge. But with the way I'm going to show you, I always get a straight edge. So look forward to that. I'm going to show you. Look, I'm going to have a little screen. I'm going to say my preferred method. I'm not sure what I'm going to say yet. But here it is. Get ready for it. So what I do is I simply chain one. And I turn my work. And so what I do is I put a single crochet into that very first stitch, or that opening you see right there. So I'm going to put a single crochet in there. So pull up a loop, two loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through two. Okay, and so what we're going to do now, so can you see those two loops there? So there's one on the left, one on the right. And I'm going to put my hook into the left loop, okay? So I'm going to stick it through the left loop, like so, get it on my hook, like so. I'm going to take it out, show you again. So stick it through that left loop, and I'm going to single crochet in here. So pull up a loop, two loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two. And so this is what I'm doing instead of the chain three, because I feel like there's less holes when I do it like this, okay? And this always gives me a straight edge. And then what I do after that is I just go straight down and double crochet into every stitch along the row. I think I show you here a little sample of what that might look like. Yeah, that's what it's going to look like when you go down with that particular turning stitch. So that's what I like to do. I just wanted to show you both options though. So here we go. Here's our single crochet swatch. Very nice, really dense. Great for like bags, hats, different stuff. But this uses a lot of yarn though. This will eat up a lot of your yarn and it's quite small. This is probably my favorite. It looks pretty dense even though it uses way less yarn than the single crochet. It looks super neat and it's great for like jumpers and stuff. Love the half double. And then for the double crochet, it uses the least amount of yarn, but it is also the highest. So we love to use that to be economical. So yeah, that is kind of it. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. Again, if you have any questions, please leave them down below. And if you have any recommendations of videos, please also leave them down below. And yeah, that is me. I really hope you guys learned a lot today. I hope I was okay at showing everything. So yeah, please remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.